Holdpeak HP-990 is a series of Tweezer-style component testers designed for measuring SMD components. Banggood.com sent me HP-990A, which I'll show you in this video. To get more information about differences of A, B and C variants, you can check the product page linked down below. Before looking at the meter itself and the accessories, let's see some highlights from the manual. Okay, maximum allowed voltage in voltage mode is 36 volts. This works with two AAA batteries. There's no dedicated power switch, but function button doubles as power key. And here are different ranges listed in this chart. And as we can see down here, this is LED or zener diode tester with the open voltage of at least 20 volts and test current of around 1 milliamp. That should be plenty for testing most SMD LEDs. RDC mode scans and measures resistors, diodes and capacitors. Correct mode should get automatically selected when a component has been detected. Rest is some stuff about changing batteries, description of display's content and so on. Where we are going, we don't need manuals. The meter and some accessories come in a plastic case. This meter has replaceable pointy tips, which seem to be gold plated. The tips have loops where you can attach banana plugs of the leads that came in the box. That is, if you want to use this like a regular multimeter. But in my opinion, these tweezer style meters are an additional measuring tool, and one will also be using a regular multimeter for other tasks. This is a handy tool for many SMD measurements, but I don't see myself using this meter with these probes. There's one pair of replacement tips in the box. They seem to be similar to the ones already attached. There are three mode selector positions in this meter: RDC, zener diode, and voltage mode. Function button can toggle between modes in the combined RDC mode. Hold button is regular data hold button. I think this mode selector switch is kinda hard to use, especially when trying to move it to the center position. It very easily moves past that accidentally, right to the other end. But maybe that is something I will learn to use later on, or maybe not. I think we are ready to attach the batteries and turn the power on. Okay, batteries are on. Let's start by testing some LEDs. This will show open voltage of around 22 volts instead of showing nothing. Does that matter? Well, it doesn't really bother me. I have some desoldered SMD LEDs here, and I would like to know which are green and which are red. Possibly voltage drop as well. The first one lights up green and meter shows voltage of 2.0 something. Next one is red with voltage of 1.8 volts. And so on. Very handy tool if you get your SMD LEDs mixed up. How about some capacitors? I have the meter in RDC mode with scanning enabled, and first capacitor doesn't show anything. Let's select capacitance mode by hitting function button a few times. This doesn't have relative button, so we have to manually do the math. The capacitance without anything connected was 36 picofarads, and this meter shows 48 picofarads for this capacitor, so I believe this is 12 picofarad capacitor. This was so minimal capacitance that this meter didn't detect anything in scanning mode. Let's go back to the scanning mode and test some more capacitors. No problems at all. 97 nanofarads. So this is 100 nanofarad capacitor. Another one shows around 10 nanofarads. Two identical looking capacitors got recognized by this meter. So far so good. This shouldn't have any problems measuring resistors, but let's try that. This first one is 10 kilo ohm, just like the marking promised. 75 ohm. Can do, no worries. So we can detect resistors automatically, but how about shorts? Excellent. This detects continuity really fast. Speaking of fast measurements, how fast is auto-ranging in resistance mode? Let's have a try. I'd say that is really fast. One important thing that I haven't mentioned yet. When holding this meter this way, top arm is the positive lead. So for example, when measuring diode's forward voltage, anode should be connected to the top arm and cathode to the bottom arm. Next up is voltage readings with 3.3, 5, 9 and 12 volts from my bench power supply. I'd like to see if there's overshoot or other funny things happening, but I'm not noticing anything like that. Another application in addition to measuring loose components is measuring stuff mounted on the PCB. That is where the voltage mode of A variation comes handy. I can, for example, measure voltages on different SMD capacitors that are on this Raspberry Pi board. I can find 5 volts present on the USB's 5 volt line, 1.2 volts probably for CPU core, and so on. Let's have a quick look inside. This meter isn't meant to be used for anything higher than 36 volts, and there are no current measuring modes, so it's kind of obvious that we won't find MOSFETs, fuses, or other input protection components inside. There is one large IC labeled ES51925A, that is 3000 count multimeter IC, so this can't be hacked into a 6000 count version, unfortunately. There are two trimmers on board for some kind of calibration. I don't know what each of those does. Apart from that, there isn't much on the board. Most likely there isn't much on the other side either. Here we can see that tweezer arms are soldered to the board, and they are semi-flexible instead of rotating around a hinge or something like that. Simple design which keeps the price low. I think this is a handy tool for special applications. This won't be replacing your regular multimeter, but this might be a very nice addition to your tool arsenal. I wish you could like this video, subscribe to my channel, and keep on hacking. Bye.